To solve triangles with vector algebra. The agenda for...
Guys in the end of the room, please. Okay, thank you.
How to solve triangles with vector algebra. Agenda for this topic is just one thing, okay? How to solve triangles with vector algebra. And I'm starting with good old trigonometry, okay? So this is what you got in the test last week. Made a little bit more practical example, so this triangle is not nicely drawn as usually triangles in trigonometry are drawn, but this is more a real case, all right? In the middle of the game, all those triangles you will work with will very rarely be aligned nicely with a horizontal and vertical edge. But what is important that we have the right angle here, okay? And now, good old trigonometry means that we have these two well-known Sokatoa formulas, okay? So the A edge and this edge. The A edge can be found as C, the hypotenuse, times sine alpha. And B can be found as C cosine alpha, okay? And everyone who said the test last week, it should be absolutely clear for you that this is the case. And of course, Sokatoa is the best thing in the world, and we will use it non-stop in this module for all the rest of your life, or maybe we say...
Hasta la vista, baby.
Hasta la vista, Sokatoa. And this is what we are going to do. A brave new world, ladies and gentlemen. Okay? Our C edge will not any longer be the C edge. Now it is a vector. Okay? A vector means that instead of knowing its magnitude, the length of C, we will know the coordinates of this vector. Okay? So that's the main assumption here, that we know the coordinates of this vector v. And we will also, because that's the basic rule of this trigonometry problem that we had in the test. We did know the length of C, and we knew something about the trigonometrical function of the alpha angle. Okay, alpha angle is here. But now we will be talking about angles in, well, vector algebra way, okay? So we will rather avoid to talk about angles. Angles mean direction, okay? Direction of this side of the vector. So instead of defining the alpha, sine alpha, cosine alpha, and this kind of stuff, we'll just have another vector, which is called here n. And this n vector is normalized, okay, it's normalized. And this other vector shows the direction of the b edge. And the question, the challenge is the same as previously. Find a and find b, okay? A and b can be represented as vectors as well, but first of all, we will look for the values or magnitudes of the lengths of these two edges, okay? So basically, the task is formulated. You have a triangle which is built on these two vectors. This is the V vector, which provides you with the hypotenuse, and the N vector, which doesn't provide you the adjacent edge, just provides you with the direction in which the adjacent edge extends. Okay, so we have no idea what the A and B could possibly be. First thing to step out from Sokatoa. We want to get rid of the C here. Okay? We will still operate with A and B because this is what we were asked to find. But now we know that there is no such thing like C anymore. We have a vector V, and C is equal to the magnitude of the vector V. It's the length of the vector V. So I will change these two formulas. And now A is equal to the magnitude of V sine alpha, sorry, and B is equal to magnitude of V cosine alpha. But it's not yet everything because it's still trigonometry, it's still sine and cosine. Next step is to remind you the formulas, the definition formulas, so both complex formulas of dot and cross product. Dot product is magnitude of V times magnitude of N cosine theta. Sorry, theta, oh, it's a small mistake, but this angle here is called alpha, and I have theta, but I have the same angle in mind. I will make a correction later, okay? Sorry for this. Basically, this cosine is of the angle between the two angles, so it's definitely alpha. And V cross N is magnitude of V times magnitude of N times sine theta. But you remember what I told you about the N vector. What kind of a vector is N? Normalized. And what's the magnitude of a normalized vector?
One.
One, exactly. So if the N is 1, then the magnitude of 1 is 1, of n is 1. So this is 1 and this is 1. And this is the example of why I quite often tell you that a normalized vector is a neutral vector in terms of its magnitude. Because if you multiply anything by the normal vector, it doesn't change in terms of normalization of a normalized, I thought normal, yeah? Sorry, normalized vector. If you multiply something particularly by magnitude of the normalized vector, it's multiplication by one. So we can just remove it from the formula and get something like this. V dot n is magnitude of V times cosine alpha. It should say alpha here. Okay. And if it did, please note that this would be the same thing as here. So this is B. And we also have the magnitude of V times sine alpha, not theta. It's multiplied by this funny normalized vector, direction vector N, which provides us with a vector nature of the cross product in 3D space. If you are not exactly sure what I'm talking about, watch the lecture about the multiplication of vectors. But the basic rule for us is very fortunately, we can totally ignore this n vector, okay? Like it wasn't here. Therefore, v dot v cross n is the magnitude of v times sine of alpha, so that's a. And we can replace the right side by b or and a, or write our solution b is equal v dot n, a is equal v cross n. And these two formulas can replace SOHCAHTOA if only our triangle is defined in terms of vector algebra. This means one more thing, that we can apply simple formulas for this calculation. So actually B will be our x coordinate of the V vector, of this vector, times x coordinate of the normal, times y coordinate of the V vector, plus y coordinate of the v vector times y coordinate of the normal vector, normalized vector, okay, n vector, okay. I'm also sometimes confused with normalized and normal, sorry for that. The beauty of this solution is that SOHCAHTOA gave you a solution in which you had sine alpha and cosine alpha. And here, in some magical way, you get the same result without using, you know, in the trigonometry test, you were asking me, can we use trigonometric functions in the calculator? Here, it will be very hard to use it because everything that you are supposed to use are two multiplications, one either addition or subtraction. End of the story. So vector algebra can make trigonometry really simple, particularly computationally simple. And this is, guys, the reason why in 3D graphics we so love vectors abnormalized directions, direction vectors. And talking about direction, we will always prefer a vector, a direction vector, okay, than an angle, because angle drags all this nasty trigonometry with it, okay? And direction vector, normalized direction vector, doesn't. What if this vector is not normalized? What if you, instead of n, we have some u vector which is not normalized?
We can normalize
them. So here are formulas, okay? But instead of remembering these formulas, you can just use a generic rule. Thank you for formulating. Normalize your vector before use, okay? And that's so often repeated in 3D graphics. Normalize your vector before use. Of course, not every vector, but in quite many situations, this will be the case. You just have to normalize the vector. So we have arrived to the take-home message.
I'll be back.
I have absolutely no idea how this ended up here. It's not what I wanted to say. That's the take-home message, okay? And that this one is right. Okay? So if you have a challenge like this, then A, this thing, is the cross product of the V and the normalized vector N, and B is the dot product, okay? And even if they are not normalized, if you don't know the normalized vector, normalization is not a big problem, and formulas are here. 2 o'clock, thank you very much.